we will discuss about the molecular diffusion in fluids, molecular diffusion in gases. Considering steady state molecular diffusion of A through the non-diffusing B, this is for the binary gas mixture. So considering there is some gas having concentration PA1 at Z1 position and PB2 or PA2 at Z2 position, and the component A is diffusing from position 1 to the position 2. So from the previous results, the general expression for the mass flux can be rewritten as Na equal to Na upon Na plus Nb dAb over Z, P over RT, ln and Na upon Na plus Nb multiplied by PT minus PA2, and similar quantity is upon here with the PA1. So when A is diffusing through non-diffusing B, then Na having some quantity Na and having some quantity with constant value, whereas Nb having zero value. So putting this value in this expression, Na upon Na plus Nb, it become a 1. When you put this value of this quantity in this particular expression, then you will get N equal to dAb over Z, PT over RT, ln PT minus PA2 minus PA1, where dAb is the diffusivity, Z is the distance between interface 1 and 2, PT is your total pressure, R is the gas constant, T is the temperature, PT is the total pressure, PA2 is the partial pressure of A at position 2, whereas PA1 is the partial pressure as PA1 at position 1. Considering this is equation 1, this is equation 2. Interface will be the constant. So here PT can be written as PA1 plus PB1. Similarly here P can be written as PA2 plus PB2. So we can write PT equal to PT minus PA2 equal to PB2, and PT minus PA1 equal to PB1, PB2 minus PB1 and PB2 minus PB1. So by combining these two pressure values, we can calculate this value. By putting this value in the equation number 2, then Na equal to dAbZ, PT over RTZ, PA1 minus PA2 upon PB2 minus PB1, ln PB2 upon PE1. This is equation number 3. So you can see here, this quantity is here, PB2 minus PB1 and ln PB2 upon PE1. This quantity can be replaced by the PBM, where PBM is the log mean partial pressure difference of the component B in between Z1 and Z2, and the PBM is defined as PB2 minus PB1 upon ln PB2 upon PB1. So PB1 is the log mean pressure, partial pressure difference, whereas PB2 the partial pressure of component B at position 2, PB1 bar is the partial pressure at position 1 of component B. And by putting this value in equation number 3, we will obtain the expression Na equal to dAb upon RTZ, PT over PBM into PA1 minus PA2. This is the expression for the diffusion of component A into non-diffusing B for gases only. So if you draw the concentration profile throughout the diffusing length Z1 to Z2, then we can see here this is the total pressure line. So here PA1 is whenever the component is diffusing from here to where, the partial pressure of component will be decreased, then it will follow this line. As well as the component B, the partial component B is stagnant, but as the A will diffuse, the partial pressure of the component B at that particular position will be increases as the component, the concentration of component A is diffusing into Z2, and at that position the partial pressure of component B will be the PB2. Always remember that the total pressure will be the summation of PB1 plus PA1, whereas at the position 2 is the PB2 plus PA2. So this, the path is showing the concentration profile of component A and component B. So this non-linearity of this particular curve is comes by the this particular ln expression. So further, steady state equipolar counter diffusion similar for the binary gas mixture. So again, considering almost similar system where one is representing interface 1 position Z1, where 2 is representing the interface 2 at position Z2. The total distance for the diffusion is Z1 minus Z2. A is diffusing in the direction of this arrow and B is diffusing in the direction of this arrow. The total pressure will be the PA1 plus PV1 equal to the PA2 plus PV2. As A will diffuse from 1 to 2, the PA1 will change to the PA2. And similarly, when component B diffuses from position 2 to position 1, then the PV2 concentration will change to the PV1. So we know that from the previous results that Na is represented as Na plus Nb, where C upon C is the concentration, minus dAb dC over dZ. So this is the convective and this is the relative flux. So for the ideal gas law, we know that CA upon C can be written as PA upon P equal to YA, and CA equal to PA upon RT. So putting this value in equation 1, then Na can be reduced as Na equal to Na plus Nb PA bar upon PT, PA bar upon P minus PAB upon RT dP over dZ. For equipolar contour diffusion, we know that A and B, so put Na equal to Nb. When we put Na equal to Nb, this component Na plus Nb becomes 0. So if we put this value is here, in that case the total remaining value will be the dAb dP A upon minus. Just a bit. In the continuation, Na become minus dAb over RT multiplied by the dP over dZ. Separating the variable for the partial pressure as well as for the Z, and integrate it for the limit Z1 to Z2 and PA1 to PA2, then we will obtain Z equal to minus dAb over RT into Na multiplied by the PA1 minus PA2. While rearranging the equation, then we will obtain Na equal to minus dAb upon RTZ PA1 minus PA2. If you see here, there is a non-linear term obtained here. So when we plot the equivalent counter diffusion concentration on PX diagram, so where Z1 is the initial position, Z2 is the final position, or position 1 and position 2, and here is the PA1 is the partial pressure of A component at position 1, partial pressure of component B at position 1, partial pressure of component B at position 2, partial pressure of component A at position 2. And you can see the total pressure is constant throughout the distance Z1 to Z2. And the plots are linear because there is a no non-linear term here. So the equipolar counter diffusion is obtained as a linear in case of binary gas mixture. Taking an example, oxygen A is diffusing through a carbon monoxide B under steady state condition with the carbon monoxide non-diffusing. The total pressure is 1 into 10 to the power 5 newton per meter square and the temperature is 0 degree is this much. Calculate the rate of diffusion of oxygen in kilomole per second through each square meter of the plane. So the given values, diffusivity, Z, R, T, partial pressure of AB. Okay. Then, this is for diffusion of A, so non-diffusion B. So the profile will be like this. And the governing equation will be Na equal to DAB upon RTZ into PT over PVM multiplied by the PA1 minus PA2. So, further, if you calculate the value of PVM, so it will be obtained as 90200 newton per meter square, and the final value of Na is 2.97 × 10⁻⁵ kilomole per meter square per second. Then next topic is molecular diffusion in liquids. So in case of liquid, the concentration is defined in the form of density, and this density is related with to the concentration by using this conversion. Simple, we know that concentration equal to number of moles upon volume, or this is the weight upon molecular weight upon volume. Then if you further, weight divided by the volume is termed as density, and this molecular weight will remain here. So C can be written as density upon molecular weight. So by putting these value, so XA can be written as CA upon C, and by putting these value in the above equation, the diffusion equation can be rewritten as Na equal to Na upon Na plus NB DAB over Z, rho upon M average ln Na upon Na plus NB minus XA2 divided by the Na upon Na plus NB minus XA1. And rho upon M average is defined as rho upon MA plus rho upon MB divided by 2. And if this replaces rho upon M and A will replace by I, then further, steady state molecular diffusion in liquids for diffusion of A through non-diffusion B. So in this case, similar to the gas phase, we are considering there are some interface as 1 and 2 and the position of Z1 and Z2, where is component A is diffusing from Z1 to the Z2. And the concentration at one position is XA1 and XB1, and the concentration at position 2 is XA2 and XB2, where N is diffusing in the direction of arrow and B is non-diffusing and this is the stagnant. So N is constant, NB equal to 0. So the quantity Na upon Na plus NB become 1. By putting the value in the previous equation, then we will obtain N equal to DAB over Z, rho upon M average ln1 minus XA2 upon 1 minus XA1. Again, this is a nonlinear term. So here will be nonlinear diffusion will occur. Since we know that the concentration at this position XA1 plus XB1 become 1 and XA2 plus XB2 again 1. So by using this identity, we can rewrite 1 minus XA2 equal to XB2, 1 minus XA1 equal to XB1, XB2 minus XB1 equal to XA1 minus XA2. Putting this value in the above equation, then there will be one more term will be in picture, that is the XBM. Similar to the log mean partial pressure difference, this is the log mean concentration difference of component B. So here, XBM will be defined as XB2 minus XB1 upon ln XB2 upon XB1, and hence the final expression for the flux N equal to dAV over Z XBM into rho over M average multiplied by XA1 minus XA2, where rho upon M average equal to 1 by 2, rho upon M 1 plus rho on M 2. In the continuation, similar to the gas phase, for liquid, for the equivalent counter diffusion can be seen in this figure, where A is diffusing towards interface 2, whereas B is diffusing towards interface 1. In this case, the diffusional flux Na equal to minus Nb equal to constant. So the sum of Na plus Nb equal to 0. So similar to the gaseous phase, we know that Na equal to dAb upon Z Ca minus Ca2. And finally, when we replace the C with concentration with rho upon M average, the expression will be the Na equal to dAb Z rho upon M average XA1 minus. For an example, calculate the rate of diffusion of acetic acid across a liquid film of non-diffusing water B 1 mm thick at 17 degree centigrade when the concentration on opposite side of the film are respectively 9 and 38% acid. The diffusivity of the acetic acid in the solution is this much, density of the solution is this much and this much. So, solution, the given values are dAb, diffusivity, Z thickness, molecular weight of the compounds, and the density of the solution. So we can calculate XA1 as 0.0288, XB1 0.9712, the molecular weight of 9% solution by using this formula, 1 upon M1 equal to WA1 upon MA plus WB1 upon MB, the molecular weight at position 1 will be the 19.21 kg per kilomole. Then, the density over molecular weight at position 1 is obtained as 52.7 kmol per meter cube. Similarly, for 3% solution, XA2 equal to 0.0092, XB2 equal to 0.9908, M2 equal to 18.4 kg per kilomol, and the value of rho upon M at position 2 is equal to 54.5 kg mol per meter cube. Putting this value to obtain the average value of rho upon M is 53.6 kg mol per meter cube. Similarly, for the value of XBM, putting the value of XA2, XB2, XA1 is obtained by putting the value of dAb, C, Z, XBM, rho upon M average, XA1 and XA2. So by putting this value in this expression, we will be obtained as 1.018 into 10 to the minus 6 kmol per meter square per second. So this is the answer for this. In this case, the diffusion will be the function of space as well as the time. So in this case, the Fick's law is modified as Fick's second law, and the both the function are related to each other as the del Ca over dt equal to minus del J over del Xa. By putting the value of Ja, the del Ca over dt can be written as a d del square C upon del X square. And finally, this is the expression for the Fick's second law. So if you plot the concentration of diffusing species into the diffusing distance, you will find at some time t1, it will follow this path. At some time t2, it will follow this path. At some time t3, it will follow this path, where t3 is larger than t2 and t2 is larger than t1. So as will time will change, the profile of the concentration profile in the diffusing species can be obtained as shown here. So as an example, assuming that copper molecules are diffusing into a bar of aluminium, where the surface concentration of copper molecules are Cs, and you can see here, these are the copper molecules, this is the aluminium bar. So as the pre-existing concentration of copper molecule in this bar is Ca naught, so this is the pre-existing concentration, and this is the molecules will going to be diffused with respect to time as well as the space. So at time t equal to 0, C is having C naught for x in between 0 to infinity. At time t is greater than 0, C equal to Cs for x equal to 0, and C equal to C naught for x equal to infinity. Okay. So again, you can see at time t, the concentration of this much is equal to this much for whole length of the bar, that is the here. For the time t is greater than 0, initially the concentration will be the Cs equal to Cs at this position, but at this position, this will be the remainder. So if you plot this concentration on the concentration versus position graph, then you will find out the at time 0 the profile like this, at t1 this, and t2 this. So for today, thank you. We will meet in next lecture.